This is a production of PBS 39.
Our next story celebrates Black history. Miss Pennsylvania, an African American, is using the power of her crown to increase autism awareness. Crystal Fisher introduces us to Rachel Marie Brooks.
It's not often that you see someone wearing a jeweled crown flipping pancakes at a local IHOP. But the current Miss Pennsylvania, Rachel Marie Brooks, says the crown grabs people's attention and allows her to get out messages for those in need.
We were celebrating National Pancake Day. IHOP has been a terrific corporate sponsor for the Children's Miracle Network, which also happens to be the national platform for the Miss America program.
Last year, IHOP raised more than $1 million for the network. Miss Pennsylvania hopes her crown will entice more people to donate.
So if you have an issue, something that's near and dear to your heart, you're able to have an even greater influence, greater impact with the title than sometimes you may be able to do without it.
But a lot comes along with wearing the crown.
A lot of people see a pageant on television that one night and they kind of assume that the girls just prance up on stage and, you know, throw on a bathing suit, throw on a gown, and that's it. The truth of the matter is that girls will spend probably 10 months out of the year preparing for that one night.
With every step on the treadmill, Rachel works to stay physically fit. She's committed to exercising every day, no matter how busy she is.
For me, I was working full-time and I was a part-time grad student preparing for Miss Pennsylvania this past year. So that meant that I was up and at the gym at 5:30 in the morning to get my workout in before I went to work.
After work, she prepared for the second part, talent.
One of these mornings.
Switching last year from dancing to singing, she had to squeeze in practicing wherever she could.
I'll be singing while I'm in the car. So you learn how to multitask.
A huge part of her multitasking consists of preparing for the Q&A portion of the pageant.
And I'll sit and read, usually in a coffee shop. Coffee shops are one of my favorite places to go, just kind of get away from things, and I'll sit and I'll read news articles that way and take notes and kind of try to anticipate the types of questions someone might ask given this story.
Often, Rachel even finds herself combining her preparations.
A lot of times I'll physically, you know, have the news on while I'm getting ready and I'm listening to stories and taking it in that way.
And last, she had to learn how to do the girly things like perfecting putting on makeup, which didn't come naturally to this 25-year-old.
A lot of us need more coaching than you can even imagine.
But the coaching paid off when she won the crown this year. And learning how to put on the right amount of blush and picking the perfect shade of lipstick were small sacrifices in the big scheme of helping people.
Realizing the power of the crown, which sounds kind of weird, but you can do so much more with it than you can without it, because for whatever reason, if you've got a big shiny object on your head, people listen to you.
Having a brother with autism, she decided to choose his disorder as her platform.
He's probably not going to marry. He won't go off to college like I had just come home from. And it just made me really, really sad.
Autism can be defined as a neuropsychiatric disorder characterized by deficits in social interaction, communication, and unusual and repetitive behavior. Rachel joined forces with Autism Speaks in hopes of making life easier for people affected with the disorder.
Right now in the Pennsylvania State Legislature, we are working on a bill that will require insurance companies to cover autism services.
The role as Miss Pennsylvania has given Rachel a chance to raise awareness all across the Commonwealth.
Having the crown has gotten me further across the state than I ever traveled before. I've literally been to the four corners of the state.
And no matter what the weather, traveling is a big part of wearing the crown. Packing for any occasion and driving across the state happens nearly every week. Miss Pennsylvania, who's from Broomall, lives with the host family while she's here in the Lehigh Valley. But she loves traveling because she can reach areas that may not have otherwise known about certain causes.
To be able to then be a bridge to folks that are kind of isolated in the middle of the state because I have this title. That was just unbelievable.
Traveling is just one of the many benefits of being a part of the Miss America organization, which was designed specifically to better women.
We are a nonprofit. We're a scholarship pageant, and that really is what this organization is about at its core. It's about empowering women to be educated and to achieve whatever their highest academic goals are.
Rachel's studying to get her master's in government, but without the help of the organization, her dreams may not have come true.
I might have had to take a semester off if not for the scholarship money that I won through the Miss Pennsylvania organization.
When her term as Miss Pennsylvania is over this June, Rachel's focus switches back to completing her master's and going for a PhD in public policy. But for the next 6 months, through acts like flipping pancakes, she's doing her best as Miss Pennsylvania to help those in need. For Tempo, I'm Crystal Fisher reporting.